Good morning, students. In yesterday's video, we have studied about balance of payment current account, right? So, current account and its components, and how we can see the balance of current account. So, I am repeating that again. When we talk about balance of payment current account, then we have studied that under current account, we record all those transactions which does not create any asset and liability. Right, for the government and the residents of the country. So, same way, when we talk about BOP capital account, as we know that there are two accounts for BOP. The very first one is current account and second account we are going to do it today only. So, capital account. Capital account, under capital account, we are going to take all the transactions between one country with the rest of the world which brings change in assets and liabilities of residents and of government. So first of all, I will read out the meaning of capital account. Capital account of BOP records all transactions between the residents of a country and rest of the world which cause a change in the asset or liabilities of the residents of country and its government. So, one simple thing is there, current account, all those transactions which are not going to create or change any asset or liability. In capital account, we are going to take all the transactions which are going to change asset and liability of the government, right? So, capital account is related to the assets and liabilities of financial nature. So, when we are talking about asset and liabilities, we are talking about the financial transaction only. We are talking about the financial assets and financial liabilities, right? So, today we will study what are the components, what are the things that we are going to add under capital account. So, due to shortage of space on the board, I have written the third component here. Then we will move to the first and second component. So, the third component of capital account is official reserve transactions. This is very important question in 3 marks, right? Official reserve transactions. These are the transactions which generally happens from the central bank of one country and the central bank of other country, or in between the governments of two countries. So this is official reserve transactions. This means this is related to the government or central bank only. So when any change occurs in official reserves, for example, when we talk about official reserve, we are talking about the foreign exchange reserves of our country, right? Any change in BOP is going to bring change in foreign exchange reserves, right? So whenever addition is made to these reserves, addition means, for example, earlier there was $1 lakh foreign exchange reserves in India. Now the foreign exchange reserves has been changed to $1,20,000. So there is addition of $20,000. This will be considered as outflow, right? Outflow means, why this is outflow? Because foreign exchange reserves will increase. When they will increase? When BOP will be in surplus, when we are earning more and we are paying them less. So whenever BOP is surplus, from that surplus BOP, whatever the extra earnings are there, they are brought to the foreign exchange reserves. Simple, it means from BOP, whatever the surplus money is coming, that we are transferring to the foreign exchange reserves of the country. So because this money is being withdrawn from the BOP, that is why this will be outflow of foreign exchange and it will be written on debit side. Debit side means negative side. And again, if withdrawal from reserves is there, for example, when we will draw the money from foreign exchange reserves, when BOP is deficit, when we don't have enough money to pay to the world, right? So when BOP is deficit, we are facing a loss. This simply means, what it means, that payments are more and receipts are less. Now, in order to fulfill that loss, what we are going to do? We are going to withdraw the money from foreign exchange reserves of the country, and then we are going to put that money into the BOP account of the country. So this means that is why when there is withdrawal from reserves is there, then this is inflow. Where it is inflow? It is inflow to the BOP account. And in BOP account, this inflow means that item is credited or this will be recorded on positive side. So simple thing is there, when money is brought from BOP to foreign exchange reserves, this will be debit, because money is going from BOP account to foreign exchange reserves, that will be debit, right? And when money will be taken out from foreign exchange reserves and it is being kept in BOP, then this will be known as credit side item and this will be known as inflow of foreign exchange. Then other two components you see, other two components are, the very first one is borrowing and lending. So what it will happen, borrowing and lending is going to affect the asset and liability of the residents and of government. So when borrowing is being done, we people are borrowing money, then this simply means we are creating a liability for us. And when borrowing of money is being done, this means we people are taking money from outside. This is inflow of foreign exchanges. There we people are taking money. So this means by the form of loan, we are receiving money. So this receiving money will be considered as inflow of foreign exchange. And when we are borrowing, this will be recorded on the credit side of BOP. So when we people are doing borrowing, when we people are taking loan, this will be recorded on positive side. And one more thing, keep in mind, when we people will repay the loan, right? So that repayment means money is flowing from India to other countries, then repayment of loan will be considered as outflow of foreign exchange and that will be debited. But when we take loan, we receive money, that will be inflow of foreign exchange only. And then when it is lending means we people are giving the loan to someone else. So when we people are lending money, we are creating an asset. Okay, so when asset is being created, when we people are giving the loan, money is going from my pocket to the other person or other country. So this is outflow of foreign exchange and this will be recorded on debit side. But when we will get our money back, when we will get our loan back, then it will be recorded on the positive side. Simple thing is there, when money is coming to the country, this will be positive or will be recorded on credit side. And when money is flowing any form from India to abroad, then that will be recorded on debit side. Then second component is investment. See, when we talk about investment, there is two type of investment. One is FDI, foreign direct investment, and the second one is portfolio investment. Foreign direct investment means we are going to foreign direct investment means we are going to buy any asset abroad, or foreigners, they are going to buy an asset, a company, a firm, right, in India, on which they are having full control, right? So foreign direct investment is any company you are going to open in any other country. So what will happen when we people are purchasing assets abroad, right? We people are purchasing the assets in abroad. This means we people are investing in other countries. In simple words, this means outflow of foreign exchange. We will spend money, we will take money from India, and then we will spend money in America or any other country of the world, right? So this will be when we people are purchasing the assets abroad, when we people are doing investment abroad, then this is outflow of foreign exchange and of course it will be debited. But when we are selling the assets abroad, whatever the company is there I have invested money in, when I am selling that company, right, so what will happen, by sale of the asset I will get my money back and I will bring it to my own country. So this will be inflow of foreign exchange and it will be recorded on credit side. Okay, so when we people are investing in other countries, this will be outflow, and when we people are selling the investments, then this will be inflow. Then portfolio investment is when people are investing money into the shares of debenture bonds of other countries, right? So here we people are not going to buy any asset. We are not going to purchase any company. We are not going to invest in any company. But we are going to invest into the shares, bonds and debentures of any company. So simple thing is there. When we will purchase the shares of any foreign company, this will be outflow of foreign exchange. Money will flow from India to abroad. And of course, this will be recorded on debit side. And if we will sell that shares, whatever we have bought, then what will happen by selling the shares? We will get our money back and the same money we will bring it to our own country. So then this will be inflow of foreign exchange and it will be recorded on credit side, right? So simple thing is there, FDI and portfolio. FDI means you are going to invest in any company. You can see that company and you are having full control over that company, right? But when it is portfolio investment, you are going to invest in shares. So you will not have full control, right? You will be having, if you have 5% shares, then your control will be 5%. If you have 20% share of that company, your control will be 20%. But in FDI, you people are having full control over the working of the company because whole company belongs to you only, right? So this is all for balance of payment capital account. First, we see the balance of payment in current account. Then we see the balance of payment of capital account, right? Whatever the inflow of foreign exchange is there, that is being added. Then we minus the outflow of foreign exchange. If inflow of foreign exchange is more than outflow, then we will say that capital account is surplus. If both are equal, inflow of foreign exchange, outflow of foreign exchange is equal, then we say that it is balanced. But if inflow of foreign exchange is less and outflow of foreign exchange is more, then we say that there is deficit in capital account, right? So, further we will do in the next lecture. Thank you.